picking up where we left off last week on the island of Jersey, we enjoy a swim on a beautiful beach, then set sail for Guernsey. Here we meet up with friends, enjoy a festival, then set sail for Alderney. We reward ourselves by eating chips. So we've arrived. Seagull's the second boat in the raft. We knew it was going to be busy, so we're quite impressed with that. Here's Alan. Very happy. Back in UK waters.
Ready for some bacon.
Ready for some bacon. We're going to head round to the office, register, and then look for a shower. We've checked in. We've had a shower. We're just looking at all the lovely sort of street furniture. Lovely wind vane, big masthead there on the Maritime Museum, massive prop. Even these nice sort of bollards with rope knots in them. It's rather lovely, isn't it? Well, we are celebrating our first morning here. We are in Jersey and full English cook breakfast. Not had one of these for 2 months. We are so looking forward to this. It's unbelievable. And the chef is very busy doing all the work. We're heading for a walk. Here's St Helier Marina. We're actually outside on the visitors' point. We're walking into town. We're going to catch a bus and we're going to go and see some of the sights of Jersey, basically. Gonna go and find a beach to have a picnic. We packed a picnic up. So we're in Liberation Square, and this is Liberation Statue to commemorate their liberation from World War II. I think it's rather lovely. It's got 12 little water fountains around it, representing each of the areas on Jersey. Really nice, an island in the middle of all this water. Very, very pertinent. Alan's feeling very hot. We just got off the bus. It was boiling. It's a very hot, sunny day today, but the bus has brought us out to Queen's Bay. What an amazing beach. Look at this. We made it to the beach. We're going to go and dally our toes. It's very cold.
Oh, look at the courage. Look at the courage. Wow, well done.
It's a bit chilly, I have to say. You're doing so well. You'll be swimming in no time. And you're off, you're in. Yay! Oh, that's brilliant.
It's freezing.
It is pretty cold, but for my daughter, who's a Yorkshire lass born and bred, it's not as cold as Heather's.
The outdoor pool.
The outdoor pool at Heather's.
That's heated. It's colder than this. Wish you were here, Abby.
We're at the bus stop. The bus stop is just like in the middle of all these sand dunes. There are just people waiting. It's a really lovely spot. There's no bus shelter, no sign. There's all these people just waiting, and on the floor there it says bus stop. That's all you get. There's the skipper.
Well, we've left St Helier Marina, visitors pontoon. Textbook bit of seamanship. It was rafted. It was good fun. And we're now coming around the southwest corner of Jersey. Tish is on the helm. might just zoom out a little. There we are. She's having a whale of a time. We're sailing. Got the motor on as well because we're slightly against the current. And so far we've had two emergency DSC calls and we've been out about 25 minutes. So we're not quite far enough away from the French headland to stop picking up the incredibly loud and invariably nonsensical, not because they're in French, but because they don't always appear to be emergencies.
We are on passage. We're on a broad reach at the moment in a force 5. The boat is sailing along super well. She's doing between 6.5 and 7 knots, so absolutely flying. There's another boat passing us, but it's going the other way. He's flying as well. We're heading to Guernsey. I think Alan might have mentioned that earlier. And we've probably got, I don't know, let me check how many nautical miles we've got to go. Oh, we've got 14.8 nautical miles to get to the tip of Guernsey. And here's the tip. Well, it's the northwest tip of Jersey. So we're off, we're having a good passage. Alan's making breakfast sandwiches. I've had mine, 6.2 knots there. Yeah, so he's made us egg, bacon, mushroom sandwiches. Very much a treat. I don't know, all the tea's on the go now, look. You can just see the edge of Alan there. Tea's in the cups. He's doing so well, so it's just a little rolly. It's not terrible, but it is enough to make cooking difficult. The skipper's down below. He's having to brace himself as we are on a bit of a tilt and we are being washed over by the waves, so we're heeling over quite a lot. He's cleaning my glasses. I feel just a little bit guilty, but I can't see very well. They're covered in salt and rubbish, so even though I cleaned them this morning, a little bit impossible to see things out in the water so clearly. We are still sailing. The miles have been eaten up. I think you might be able to see, I think that's Sark over there. We've seen a few fins in the water, but nothing we managed to film. I think the skipper might have something for me. My glasses, thank you. This is our approach to Guernsey. Most of it's shrouded in fog, but we can actually see one corner there. We're heading towards the, it's probably the southwest corner of Guernsey, and heading up a channel when we get there. Probably got about an hour to go. It's about 3 miles to the sort of headland, and then about 3 miles up the channel into St. Peter's Port. So we're nearly there, having a good see at the sail. Sails, as you can see, doing their work. We've had the engine on for about an hour, but we're actually in neutral because we don't need to go any faster, but we wanted to charge our batteries a bit. You can see islands around us, see little boats on the horizon. So yeah, have a great trip. We've slowed down a bit from earlier. You can see only doing 5.7 now, but that's fast enough because we're nearly in. Thank you. Here we are entering Guernsey St Peter's Port. Never been in before. It's really wet, really drizzly and rainy. There are a lot of boats in here on moorings, and there's meant to be sort of floating pontoons, walk ashore pontoons, marinas. We are really not sure where we're going, but we've been told to come down this sort of fairway that's marked with red and green buoys, and somebody will come and show us where to go. So that's what we're doing. That looks like the row berth for the ferries. We come from out there. So we've arrived in St Peter Port, Jersey. No, Guernsey. We're moving so fast I can't keep up. We just arrived. Alan's got the registration form and the rubbish. We're moored up against our friends on Aquila. And we've got a walk ashore pontoon. Luxury. So here we are, posting our form in the customs box. We've officially arrived. This is the inner harbour over the sill, looking pretty busy. They did say they got a rally in, and we can see ahead of us the town. Going to explore. So, having a walk around, this is the sort of beach area, but it's high water in St Peter's Port, and it's also an anchorage. You can see a yacht out there at anchor. We've just sailed out of Guernsey. This is Herne. It's a lovely bright day. Beautiful sunshine, light winds today. We have got our jib out, which you can probably see through our spray hood. We haven't had enough sea room to get our main out yet. We're quite close to Guernsey. So here's Guernsey, quite shallow. So we've not managed to get the main up. But so far, lovely. Only going slow because we knew we'd be fighting the tide for a couple of hours. But we'll pick up in a little while. We're heading to Alderney. Beautiful day. So we've cleared Guernsey this side and Herne that side, and we are heading up the channel towards the Alderney race. We've got full sails out. We've got light winds, so between 6 and 10 knots. 6 knots is a bit light for us to sail on its own, so we're motor sailing for a little bit. 10 knots would be okay, but it's quite variable. Doing about 6.7 knots over ground, so we're flying along, no problems at all. And this evening we should be probably anchored or on a mooring ball in Braye Harbour in Alderney. Really looking forward to yet another Channel Island. We've had a great time on Guernsey. Really enjoyed it. We went to the Occupation Museum and found lots out about the history of the island, which is something I certainly didn't know. It was quite wet, and today is beautiful, so today is the day to sail. Here's the sails. Oh wow, looking great. I don't know whether you'll be able to see. I'm going to show you around the corner here and see if you can spot Alderney. So Alderney is there in the distance. I can see it, but it's not always easy to see these things on camera. I'll try zooming in. You can just see it on the horizon with some clouds above it. That's where we're heading. We are sailing in company. This is Aquila behind us. She's crewed by David, Georgina and Livy. And they're heading to the same place as us. Tomorrow we plan to cross the channel, the English Channel that is, and head over to not Swanage, Studland Bay. So hopefully we get the right weather for that.
Here's our friends on Aquila. We're just making our way to Alderney, and they're trying to show us the smiley face. There it is on the back of the boat. They're very keen that we see the smiley face. They left after us, and now they're just overtaking us, so we won't be racing them, but we will be seeing the smiley face en route.
Here's a view of Alderney. We're coming through the Alderney race. Absolutely beautiful. Just coming around the north is Tip, so we can go into Braye Harbour. That's stunning. And behind us, off the stern, you can see the tip of France. So Cherbourg is over there. So we are as far north as we can get before having to cross the channel. So we've come around the tip of Alderney. You can see German fortifications on the left-hand side on the tip. Beautiful lighthouse. In the middle of the shot is a German lookout point. It's just great. We're just heading, towards the harbour. And the harbour is there. You can just see the breakwater on the right and lots of boats inside. That'll be our stop for the night. Well, we've made it. We're on a mooring buoy. We're in Braye Harbour. There's the beach. And we are going to put our investigation trousers on. We're going to get in the tender and we're going to go and see what's ashore. We haven't got long, so we're just going to get on with it. We've come ashore, the dinghy's down there. We've found the ramp. This is the ramp to go ashore. Somewhere up here is the skipper, probably tapping his watch. The sun's setting, you know. Hurry up. And there we go. Well, we made it to Braye Chippy. Lucky us.
We've arrived in Alderney, and the only way we can bathe the island is if I eat something or drink something hot. So this is my hot food. It's not that I'm hungry or that I'm a greedy pig. It's because I need to bathe the island.